My name is Vera Franco, and these are the startling tales about radical responsibility. This star is about a very common, very popular survival strategy called the White Widow strategy, or also the Grey Widow and the Black Widow. These three widows is the survival strategy of using and mixing your sexual energy in human interactions with the purpose of survival. To be clear, all widows can be men and women. And so I'm going to start with a black widow, because the three different levels of the three different colors of the widows, they have to do with the level of depth of connection, like deep into the underworld. So we start with the deepest one, the black widow. Black widows come from a background of heavy sexual abuse. Also, to be clear, not all sexual abuse leads to a black widow. But all black widows have sexual abuse in their background. The purpose of a black widow is, just like the animal, just like the famous spider, is to use sex to attack, destroy, kill, and take revenge. So in human interactions, a black widow, someone using the black widow survival strategy, would have an unconscious desire of hate the opposite gender, or the gender that caused this abuse to them, and to take revenge. They will often subvert meetings, take down gatherings that are happening, and discredit, for example, the authority figure, if that's the gender of the in question. And they will often sit in circles. For example, they will sit right in front of the alpha male or the alpha female, and just with open legs, in a kind of defiant and predatorial attitude. So they are really easy to spot from their predatorial kind of energy. And they use a lot of seduction and flirtation for just getting everyone's attention to do their revenge. Now, black widows don't usually come to transformational trainings. And this is because their life is dedicated to revenge. And so this is their life purpose. And if they really choose to transform them, it's too scary for them to lose that life purpose. They might die. So it's not really common for them wanting to transform. Now, the Grey Widow. Grey Widow, we're going up the elevator of the depth of underworld. The Grey Widows also come with a lot of sexual abuse in their background. And it could be not physical sexual abuse. It could be a lot of energetical sexual abuse. And what happens is, when there's a lot of energetic, particular, not just energetic, but also physical sexual abuse went to a child, the child doesn't know whose body it is, where are my boundaries, and is often confused about using sexual energy a lot in their environment. It becomes kind of a normal thing. And so a Grey Widow is kind of a person who'd ooze sexuality. They would walk into a space and everybody, men, women, everybody would just turn their heads and then feel even like erotic energy coming into the space. The purpose of the Grey Widow is, again, to use sexual energy. It is to get everyone's attention, and it's to manipulate and control the space so that they're safe. And it has this, they have to be the center of attention. If they're not the center of attention, they might die. They might not be worthy. And so this is very common in like pop stars, actresses and actors, where it's all about sexuality, you know, like really big cleavages, like all their clothes is to enhance features of their body so that sex is in the space. And so they have dedicated their life purpose for sexuality as their identity. Now, the White Widow, we go up the elevator, and it seems like it's the most kind of, it has more an innocence in it, and it has a lot of underworld anyway. And it's the most common survival strategy. The White Widow, they use and manipulate their own sexual energy to be safe, to be heard in a space, to get attention, to get someone to do something, a favor for them, something that they don't want to do, or just to have a string of people around their little finger in case they're needed for something, or in case they're feeling lonely or they're feeling bored, and so they can get this energy from other people. For example, if you are a white widow, you would often do like drink from another person's glass, be playing with your hair a lot. Especially if you're a woman, you'd be playing with your hair a lot, but also like more energetic, subtle cues, like having your attention, always a little bit of your attention. I call it pinging, like sending a ping to that man over there, or sending that ping to a woman over there, knowing where every man, or like if you're a man, like where every woman on the room is, from what angle they're looking at you from, and if they're having a good angle. And so, and there's a constant engine running, and it's only survival. And so this survival strategy of all three widows are extremely unconscious, but they're very taxing, because you have a whole part of your whole being committed to doing this whole work of scanning, of looking for other people, to have psychic sex, to see, am I attractive? If I'm not attractive, I'm not worthy. And so it's really taxing energetically. And it means you don't have your attention with you. Your presence is very diluted because it depends on how other people are perceiving you. And it's also almost impossible to have authentic, intimate relationships. For example, white widow men, they cannot have a friendship with a woman. And white widow women, they cannot have a friendship with men. Not real friendships, not ones that have, that are clear and not ambiguous. I am a recovering, almost gray widow, actually. And it broke my heart when I found out that I had so many male friends, and I actually did not know how to be friends with men. So these are the bad news. The good news is there is a way out. There is a way of extracting yourself from the prison of your survival strategy. The process is a process of 1 to 2, sometimes 3 years, depending on the level of addiction to that sexual energy strategy, to not have any physical contact with the gender, the whole gender of people that you would normally do this interaction with. No physical contact, no looking in the eyes, and really not spending any time, unless it's really absolutely necessarily, logistically necessary, spending time with them, because you are probably aware of flirtation, of some sexual energy exchange, but you're not aware of some that might be really invisible and they're more subtle. And only, it's just like an addiction of alcohol, only by going completely cold turkey you can really see how much like tentacles that survival strategy had on you. The benefit from this is that you get your energy back, you get your life back, you get your aliveness back. All of this engine running, does he like me? Am I attractive? Am I going to be heard in this space? Can people even see me? All of this is going to be gone. Like, imagine you're in a house that has these, you know, these electronic devices humming all the time, and it just, they turn off, and there's this amazing space inside of you. It's exactly like that. You have so much more space. And also you have more energy to do whatever it is that you want to, for your projects and for your relationships. Because pinging and doing the whole engine, the whole motor with other people, it really takes your energy away. Because every time you do psychic sex, every time you exchange your sexual energy with someone else, it creates a leak, creates a little leak of your bucket, for your bucket of sexual, of life energy. And so instead of leaking it all the time with this guy that you saw in the street, this woman that you saw at a party, you have that in yourself for your projects, for your life. And you can have an extraordinary relationship with the partner or partners that you would like to be with. If you want to know more about this, please visit the website whitewidow.mystridently.com for more experiments, and you can reach out to me. Thank you.